what is most difficult in this world? Easy, staying engaged on the spiritual path, staying engaged with familiarity with truth, staying engaged with the wow. That is the most difficult task there is here. And so if you're doing that, you're doing the best that you can in this world for sure. Because the distractions and the pressure here are simply unfathomable. They're so extreme. So what we are doing is we are staying engaged, staying engaged, staying engaged. And as we stay engaged, we're walking together in the wow. The wow is this unique feeling as we get glimpse success, we glimpse reality. We see our mistake, and we feel this elation mixed with some trepidation, like, oh my gosh, this is a game changer. So we sort of have this wow feeling that is unique to the spiritual path. And it's managing our success on the spiritual path, which is the most important aspect of it. And how we manage our success, we call it walking together in the wow. This is all those on the spiritual path are walking together in the wow. They're having success as they go along. They're having success. And the success does bring this feeling that is, I feel, is best expressed by just saying, wow. There's really nothing more one can say, because we're going to the accepting the abstract, that which is completely abstract. And we cannot verbally put it in a verbal box or in a conceptual box. Where perfection cannot be put into a verbal conceptual box. And so, you know, we have this feeling that transcends description. And we'll just let it go as like a wow. Wow, this is just wow. So we have a few graphics here to help you stay engaged. I know it's quite difficult staying engaged, but this is what it takes. This is what it takes. Maybe you don't have a success you're hoping for. You want to be finished. Well, it's not so easily finished, because of our extreme continuity fear of being used to what we believe is imperfection. And so perfection just simply seems to be outside the boundaries of anything that we think we can reasonably experience, you know, or at least familiar, outside the bounds of any familiarity whatsoever. But keep in mind that actually the hallucination of problems, of a flawed reality, that was outside of anything that we have ever experienced. And we have gotten used to it through tremendous reinforcement. So we have to gradually let this continuity fear evaporate, which it does. It does evaporate. I'm going to use an example here. This book, Spaciousness, The Radical Zogchen of the Vajra Heart, a translation by Keith Dalman of the great Tibetan master Longchenpa. I saw that I'd ordered it in November of 2013, I believe it was. November of 2013. So it's been about a year and a half since I've ordered this book, and it came about a week later. And I just have been looking through it the last couple days, and I can see how much more familiar I am with it now than a year and a half ago. It's quite extraordinary, where it all feels familiar and comfortable. And I say, yeah, I'm familiar with what's being said here, and I get what's being pointed out, and I'm on that track. And so a year and a half to gain familiarity with an ultimate teaching, an ultimate pointer to reality. You see, that's very good progress. Very good progress. That's the kind of book that is a challenge. Is a great challenge. So familiarity is super important. You have to stay engaged with the spiritual path. It's not something you do as a dilettante and you do it once a month or something. There's no way. You don't do it that way. You have to keep yourself engaged. So what I try to do is I try to put out consistent videos here to help you stay engaged. All right, this is what is crucial. Stay engaged. This is what keeps the momentum going. Okay, so with these graphics, let's see if I can, I've put a whole bunch of them here, and I will just can almost even randomly just throw some up there because they're all good. And they're assertions. A lot of them are assertions that what we need to practice. Let's throw this one up here. What does this say? Oh, okay. This is the practice that we are engaged in here. We make assertions. We practice full stop in the wow. As these assertions gain traction within our mind, it's just like, wow, am I really doing this? Am I really saying this? I mean, wow. And then flipping the script is a way to get back on track from the wow, back into the assertions, where we kind of talk and brainstorm and bring up ideas about how to view, what's the trouble we have, what's the trouble we having, how can we get past it. So these are the three aspects of the practice. Now, having a structure in this world is quite important on the path. Having a structure on the path is very important. This is what I'm finding. As it gets more and more intense, you want to have a structure that you say, I do have a structure I can fall back on, especially when the world challenges you, as the world will challenge you and challenge you and challenge you and say, you're crazy, what are you doing, you're falling into an abyss, you know, that you can't find safety, or you cannot find salvation there, or identity or life or anything. And the egoic belief system will certainly try to undermine you. And if you are able to say, no, I know I have a practice that I can rely upon, then it calms you down to a great extent and enables you to keep your momentum going, which is, again, staying engaged, produces this momentum where you are able to get familiar with even the highest teachings. And what they're pointing to is to go beyond even these highest teachings to actually experiencing the perfection that is actually the case right now. It's always the case right now. It's already here. We're just hallucinating a problem. That is right. We are just misperceiving. We are misperceiving. Okay, we are misperceiving. Meaning we're not seeing what is there. We're seeing something else. We're hallucinating something else. That's a misperception. So our practice is assertions and then full stop in this feeling, this wow feeling, and then working on clarifying. Work on clarification, and then you can either go back to the wow, that clarification brings up a wow feeling, or you go back to assertions. So we do have a structure here, and this helps you stay engaged, and you at any time during the day you can say, what aspect of the path am I on right now? Am I making assertions right now? Let us see if we can click in an assertion here. Okay, here's an assertion. The flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. The flaw that I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been there for me. The flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. Okay, so the way we practice assertions is to, if I can dial that up, okay, is to assert that we're already experiencing this. And then I give this advice in all assertions, all affirmations, all prayer, okay, all mean the same thing actually, is we practice as if we've already received the response that we've asked for. And so we're basically saying, wow, the flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. In other words, we're saying, wow, I've already received the answer for the prayer. I'm already seeing the answer. I'm already seeing the answer. I'm already experiencing it. So this is a very advanced way, but this is the effective way that we need to really succeed, is to imagine that we've already succeeded. We've already succeeded, and we're just feeling this wow of gratitude, sort of elation, trepidation, and gratitude. It's just, wow, the flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. Okay, I'm just clicking on it. I'm not sure what's going to come up. Okay, here we go. I always pray as if I have already received what I want, and am thanking God for this. Okay, this is how we assert, pray, affirm. I always assert, pray, affirm, as if I have already received what I want, and am thanking God for this. All right, again, I always pray as if I have already received what I want, and am thanking God for this. We're so thankful that we've gotten this response. Okay, very thankful we've gotten this response. Okay. For instance, healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Perfect example here. And indeed, healed perception is the only attainment, because what we are suffering from is we are trying to see a flaw in reality. Why? And you know the answer is, this is how we're trying to pretend that we're greater than God. That we turn reality into an object, and we're the subject, and we're looking at this object, and we're saying, aha, I see a flaw. It really isn't perfect. God told us it was perfect. God said God's perfect. All is perfect, but we see a flaw. And so by the fact that we've identified a flaw in what claimed to be perfect means that we are somehow, you know, better than this so-called perfection, because we were able to see something that perfection couldn't even see, a flaw in perfection. So we feel we're greater than God. The catch to this is that we're hallucinating this perfection, or we're rather over simply denying, overlooking what is here. Perfection doesn't have any flaw. Perfection doesn't have any flaw. But we're insisting, oh yes, it has a flaw. That's called a misperception. It's called a misperception. So all we really need to do, all we really need to do is we need healed perception. That's it. So healed perception is the only attainment, and I've already attained healed perception. I've already attained it. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. This is how you should affirm, how you should believe, and how you should practice. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. My perception is already healed. Yes, I already know that my perception is already healed. Yes, I already know that my perception is already healed. How about that? Yes, I already know that my perception is already healed. The more we get familiar with this, the better it is for us. We want to get familiar with success. And you might say, well, how can I get familiar with success if I haven't yet succeeded? By using these affirmations. Today I celebrate my healed perception. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. Today I celebrate my healed perception. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. See? So we're now rehearsing as if we've succeeded. Not only have we succeeded right now, but we're saying all my days are holy. Now all my days are holy. So today I celebrate my healed perception. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. Today I celebrate my healed perception. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. This means that we are seeing reality as it is, without the flaw that we thought, that we believed, that we desired to be there, without that imagined flaw. Without that imagined flaw. And this flaw has to do with what we call pure spaciousness. It has to do with what we call pure spaciousness. The flaw has to do with believing that that appearances, whatever the appearance may be, has somehow it affects pure spaciousness. That pure spaciousness is somehow affected by, somehow fixated by appearances, or motion, appearances. Somehow pure spaciousness is being fixated, okay, fixated, crystallized, changed, altered. This is just a willful misperception, a willful desire on our part. We're not even seeing this. We just think we are. We just believe we are. We're not seeing it because it's not there. Pure spaciousness has no attributes. It has no attributes to crystallize or fixate at all. Okay, it is this pure emptiness, as it were, pure zero-dimensionalness, as it were, that this bottle is in spaciousness, right? Not just space, but we see the space outside and the space inside, but pure spaciousness also includes the glass here is also abiding in pure spaciousness. It occupies area, does it not? This is the area that is occupied, is pure spaciousness. It doesn't matter, you know, how you turn it. This is still has an appearance in pure spaciousness. And everything is mere appearance in pure spaciousness. This is fundamental truth of reality. And what we are doing is we are believing that somehow everything that we're seeing is somehow binding, fixating, crystallizing, concretizing, changing, moving, altering, corrupting, defiling, making better, making and transcending, enhancing, whatever. Somehow it is affecting pure spaciousness. And in fact, it is not. It is not affecting pure spaciousness whatsoever. It's just a wishful thinking, where the perception that we have is in our mind, and it's just wishful thinking. When we see objects, they're not really doing what we think they're, believe they're doing at all. They're not, it's not there at all, actually. It's like a phantom, but it's in our mind. We want to believe that this is true, because that would mean in our minds that we're greater than God, that reality is not perfect. So this is called a mistaken perception, false perception, and our goal is healed perception. Our goal is healed perception. Now, or normal perception, or, you know, right perception. And so we're getting hearing this, and we're getting used to it. We hear it, and we get used to it. We don't have to prove anything to the ego. We don't have to detail anything, excuse me, to the ego. Our goal is to get familiar with this, the truth. That's all. Not to prove anything to the ego. We're not teachers here giving a test saying this has to be proven, et cetera, et cetera. We are not engaging with the ego at all. We are spending our time simply hitting the highlights, okay, to get used to. Just these are highlights that we can get used to. Today I celebrate my healed perception. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. So we hear the term enlightenment tossed around, and yet here we're putting it in perspective and putting it in right context. His healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. My perception's healed. Yes, I already know. My perception is already healed, and I'm already enlightened. Absolutely. I already know that I'm healed perception is enlightenment, and I'm already enlightened. I already know. Yes, I already know that healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. I have healed perception. My perception has been healed. And I simply have dropped this idle wish that there's some fixation with pure spaciousness. There is no fixation there. It's just dropping this idle wish that there be some fixation in pure spaciousness based on appearances and this display, based on display in pure spaciousness. It's just dropping that idle wish. It's just an idle wish. It doesn't have any effects at all, actually. It doesn't have any causation, has no effects. What has no effects has no causation, really. And this idle wish doesn't have any effects. It does not affect pure spaciousness at all. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I'm already enlightened. Okay. The vision of holiness already graces my vision. I am already enlightened. Yes, I already know that the vision of holiness already graces my vision, and I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened because the vision of holiness already graces my vision. Yes, I know I am already enlightened. The vision of holiness already graces my vision, the vision of holiness, which is the vision of oneness. It is the vision of Christ. You could say it is Buddha vision. It is the vision of sameness. It is the vision of God, actually, the vision of holiness. This is to say the holiness means that pure spaciousness is wholly without any fixation whatsoever. It is completely without any fixation. In other words, there are no wrinkles in pure spaciousness. There are no wrinkles. There's no seams. It's wholly seamless. There's the vision of holiness. And you're seeing that this is so everywhere. There's no fixation whatsoever. And this was what brings what we call peace of mind to us. Our mind then becomes at peace. We say, oh, there isn't any problem. I don't have to fix anything. There's nothing wrong with me. There's nothing wrong with reality. There's nothing needs to be transcended or fixed. And all is well, all is well, all is well. And then you just enjoy this seamless this holiness, this seamless spaciousness. So again, we are getting used to this material, getting used to it, getting familiar with it. This is the art of the spiritual path, is familiarity. Familiarity wins. Familiarity succeeds. One has to be humble here, because we're not aiming to go to somebody and tell them off and say, I know it's true, you know, this, because we've memorized something. No, we're going way beyond that. We are hearing this and accepting it and allowing ourselves to get familiar, saying, this is the truth. I know it's the truth. And I know all I need to do is just get familiar and used to this and settle into it. So the vision of holiness already graces my vision. I am already enlightened. Yes, I know, I'm already enlightened. I am already enlightened. And by doing this, we gradually evaporate the fear of we're not worthy, we're not deserving. Who are we to be enlightened? Well, who are we to see a flaw in reality that doesn't exist? This is a better way to flip the script. Who are we to see a flaw in reality that doesn't even exist? So really, we are simply transitioning back to normal here, okay? We're merely transitioning back to normal. The vision of holiness already graces my vision. I am already enlightened. The vision of holiness already graces my vision. I am already enlightened. Okay. All right, very great. I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned upon my mind. I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned on my mind. I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned upon my mind. So again, once we see the vision of holiness, which is that there is no fixation in pure spaciousness, no appearance has caused any fixation whatsoever, that's the end of the path. We've finished the path. It's already finished. We're already enlightened. See? I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned upon my mind. That's it. There isn't nothing else we need to do. There isn't anything else we need to do except to exchange false perception for healed perception. That's it. That's all that we need to do. Now we may be feeling this, that's easy. I thought it was all esoteric and difficult. No, it's not at all. Being all esoteric is a way to please the ego, because the ego wants me to believe that it's all very complex, and there's so many difficulties and if you know, lots of iffiness to it and doubts and also making it real complicated makes it seem like we're working on some sort of solution. You know, we want to be able to fix something that isn't quite right, as if something might be a little bit out of alignment. As if alignment is even possible in pure spaciousness, which it is not. Everything is absolutely always abiding in the totality of pure spaciousness. There's no up or down in pure spaciousness, so there's nothing to be aligned with, nothing to be out of alignment with. It's not possible. As I've said, with the bottle, a nice little prop here is that, you know, this is 100% in pure spaciousness. So is this. So is this. Okay? So is this. This is 100% in pure spaciousness. So is this. So is this. And this. And this. And this. And this. And this. 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 You see? That too. Is this leaving pure spaciousness now? Is it somewhere else? Is it 99% in pure spaciousness? Or is it 100%? It's still 100%, right? So there's no such thing as alignment with reality. There's no such concept. There's no up, down, this way, that way, more true, less true, more inclusive, less inclusive. Every pure spaciousness is totally inclusive. All appearance arrives in this totally inclusive, infinitely vast matrix of pure spaciousness. I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned upon my mind. And now we will take a look at this. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. And remember, we're using the best tools that I have come up with so far in our practicing here, where we are simply asserting. And we are asserting in the form of I'm already succeeded. I already know that I'm already experiencing healed perception. This is the most potent form of assertion or affirmation or prayer. And we are simply full stop in the wow when we feel reaction to it. We're not trying to prove anything to the ego. We're certainly not trying to prove the ego wrong. See, the ego will try to bait you into either proving that it's wrong or congratulate you on proving that you're right. We're not proving anything here. We are simply getting familiar with truth. Okay? We're not doing any accounting either. Okay? We're not counting strokes like in golf or in something. We're not counting runs or anything. We're not counting. We're not keeping account of anything. We are simply allowing familiarity to set in. And familiarity is a very vague situation. It's it's a holistic sort of total situation that you can't delineate it really. But we know it when we feel it, when familiarity is set in. We know it, don't we? We look and say, oh, I'm familiar with this. This doesn't cause me much, you know, I don't get rattled. I feel calm. I feel comfortable with this. So I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. So what we're doing in these videos now is we're shifting gears a little bit and we're engaging a little more directly now. I feel it's necessary to help everyone out here, because the pressure in the world is off the charts. But again, we're not trying to delineate the world so much, what's going on. We are trying to get familiar with the remedy, and the remedy is very simple. The remedy is healed perception. The remedy is healed perception. It's that simple. The remedy is truly that simple. We simply allow ourselves to see, to recognize, to realize, oh, there isn't any fixation in zero-dimensional pure spaciousness. Attributeless, dimensionless, pure spaciousness. There isn't any fixation at all. It's totally fixation-free. Totally fixation-free. We simply allow ourselves to recognize this. That's it. The entire spiritual path. That's all we need to do. Nothing more than that. Nothing less than that either. Yes. You're right. Nothing less. And, you know, all of our frantic efforts, spiritual efforts, if we look in hindsight, it was much of it had to do with trying to do something less than this. You know, we say, well, or more or less, one of the two, but avoiding simply seeing, simple seeing, simple recognition, which takes place in the mind, not with the body senses. The body senses really don't see anything at all. It's the mind that is doing the seeing. And so we've been trying to do something less, more or less, and it's very difficult, struggling, and we don't need to do more or less, we need to do just this. I already know that I'm already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I'm already experiencing healed perception. Since simply seeing, recognizing that pure spaciousness is not fixated at all, that is all that anyone will ever have to do, period. And it's always exactly that simple. It's always exactly that simple. No one will ever have to do anything other than that. Okay? It doesn't matter what labels are put upon your search, your path, your belief, your faith, your tradition. The fact of the matter is nobody, no spirit, no one will ever have to do anything except to recognize that pure spaciousness is not fixated in any way. Okay, that's it. So why do we need to get all caught up in labels, religious labels, spiritual labels, labels of all different types, conceptual explanations of all different types? There's no need to. There is absolutely no need to. So we don't get caught up in that. We just say, I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I am already experiencing healed perception. What is healed perception? It's nothing more than the recognition that pure spaciousness is not fixated in any way. There's no fixation whatsoever in pure spaciousness. No fixation whatsoever in pure spaciousness. No fixation whatsoever in pure spaciousness. Okay, now let us see if we've already gone over these here. Yes, we have gone over this. So we're going to go to this one now. And we've done this one. Today I always pray. We've done this one too. The flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. The flaw that I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. And again, healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. Here we go. Healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. Now, it's important to use this already term, because the fact is the flaw that we think we're seeing isn't there. There is no fixation present. So it's not like we have to get rid of something. It's not like we have to step over something. It's not like we have to push something out of the way. It's not like we have to defeat something. It's not like we have to transcend a flaw. So no transcendence, no fixing, no moving it out of the way, no going around it. Nothing that we need to do. Healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. The arrival is simultaneous arrival. It's concurrent. It's immediate. It's instantaneous, because there's nothing that precedes it in terms of doing something. It's not like we push the flaw out of the way and then we've arrived. There's nothing to push out of the way. So we it's super helpful to practice with the already-ness. My healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. Okay, healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. What's this going to be? I'll just click. I don't know what I'm going to see. Okay. Very great. The theme for today as I woke up this morning was, I asked the Holy Spirit for help, and the Holy Spirit said, just say this today. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Okay. What is the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is simply the vision of reality as it is. And so this vision of reality as it is brought to us, as it were. It's presented to us. It's there for us. And so we say the Holy Spirit is presenting healed perception to me. See, Holy Spirit is our spirit perceiving reality as it is, whereas it's a blessing of God upon our spirit. The Holy Spirit is actually a blessing of God, the prime creator, upon our spirit with seeing reality as it is, knowing reality as it is, perceiving reality as it is. The Holy Spirit is the mediator between mistaken perception and healed perception, and then between healed perception and knowing. So the Holy Spirit knows healed perception, is a way to say it. So Holy Spirit equals what? Healed perception. The Holy Spirit, healed perception. Today is a Holy Spirit day. Today is a healed perception day. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Equate the two in your mind. Holy Spirit means what? Healed perception. 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 It's that simple. We do not have to get into complex religious debates at all anymore. The time for that is now gone, actually. At least here it is. This has been a long path of trying to get past all of this massive swamp of disputes and arguments and debates and discussions and back and forth and, you know, a massive waste of time. Massive, but the ego loves all that stuff. Massive waste of time. All we need to do is remind ourselves, oh, Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. It's that simple. Just keep it that simple. Just keep it that simple. So we're working on getting familiar with simplicity, free of all of the entanglements that the ego has churned out and uses to pull us back into struggling, and feeling as if we need to fix something, get something out of the way, you know, jump over something, move it, split it in half, pulverize it, get, you know, defeat it. No, there isn't anything there to defeat. There isn't any fixation in pure spaciousness. So there's nothing to get rid of. Just see it as it is. So Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Another way to say it is Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. If you prefer to say it that way, that is fine. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Vision of Christ means you see pure spaciousness and you recognize there's no fixation in it whatsoever. No fixation in it whatsoever. Christ actually means anointed with oil. And of course, in oil, it's a symbol of no fixation, isn't it? If you look at oil, where do you see fixations in oil? It has this unique capacity to remain unfixated for a long time, doesn't it? It doesn't crystallize. Okay? So it doesn't get defiled, it doesn't get contaminated. You know, oil is a symbol for pure spaciousness, actually. So the term, for instance, Jesus Christ was Jesus, the anointed one, the one who's been anointed with oil, meaning the one who has the vision of holiness, the vision of healed perception, the vision of no fixation and pure spaciousness. It's the one who sees reality as it is. So Jesus, who sees reality as it is. Or Jesus, the one who has the vision of Christ, the vision of pure spaciousness, seeing that there's absolutely no fixation, no crystallization whatsoever in it. And thus there are no reference points or point to for anything to be aligned with. So in other words, so there's no judgment needed. Everything is equally holy. Everything is equally sacred. Everything is equally included. Everything is in perfect abidance and being with God. Because there is no fixation in pure spaciousness whatsoever. So Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. This is another way to equate the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Now, another way to look at it, if you prefer, is Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Meaning, every appearance has the exact same basic condition in relation to pure spaciousness as every other appearance. All appearances have exactly the same relationship, and that is they're not out of sync whatsoever. They're not out of alignment. They're 100% completely floating in perfect inclusiveness in unfixated pure spaciousness. So this is healed perception. Another way to term is vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Now, you know, you may have a preference for these, or you may like them all. So you can say Holy Spirit, healed perception, Holy Spirit, vision of Christ, or Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. All is one. All is one inclusiveness. All, we're in one family. All appearance is this one family of pure inclusion, absolute, without any possibility it could ever not be included, since there's absolutely no reference point to go nearer or farther from, or to be closer in alignment, or to, you know, this alignment or that alignment, or to be more like this or less like this, etc. The attributeless, qualityless, zero-dimensional pure spaciousness. You see, you cannot be more like it or less like it or nearer or farther. It's impossible. So Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. 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 So this is a very good key to use in your day. You can just use one of these keys. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. And remember, Christ means, like, as if anointed by oil, and oil is a symbol for pure spaciousness. It means no fixations, smooth, seamless, no fixations, no crystallizations whatsoever. And the vision means you're aware of this, you're seeing it, you're aware of it. I'm aware there are no fixations in pure spaciousness. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. What do we have here? I'll click on this. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Okay, Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Again, all appearance, no matter what its motion, its quality, arising or subsiding, it has the exact same relationship to pure spaciousness as all other appearances. Nothing more or less. There's no more and there's no less. There's nothing that can be said about it. It's exactly the same. It's exactly the same. It's exactly the same. This bottle here and this bottle here have exactly the same relationship to pure spaciousness as one another. There's zero difference. Completely zero difference. It doesn't matter their motion, their relative location. In relation to pure spaciousness, everything has absolute location in pure spaciousness. There's no relativeness whatsoever. It's absolute, 100% perfectly included. So vision of sameness, Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. The Holy Spirit brings the vision of sameness. The Holy Spirit is the vision of sameness. The Holy Spirit brings both is and brings the vision of sameness, which is enlightenment. Now, what do we have here? Ah, okay. This is something we can say over and over. Holy Spirit, healed perception. 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 And this is something we can say all during the day. This is a wonderful repetitive assertion that we can make all during the day constantly. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Or Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Or Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Or Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Okay. Our Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. And the more we say this, the simpler we make everything for ourselves. We realize it's that simple. It really is that simple. Okay, we're going to see what this graphic says. I already know my perception is already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. Very great, powerful, because it's true, isn't it? The flaw that we believe is that we are seeing isn't there. It's already not there. It's never been there. So I already know my perception is already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. There's nothing I need to do. It's already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. Now, we might be feeling somewhat of the burn of the wow at this point. And let us just see if we can keep going. Sort of tough it out here, because this is very powerful here. Very powerful. I already know my perception is already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. Really, healed perception is just waiting for us. Because it's just merely an acknowledgement of reality as it is. Exactly as it is right now. I already know that reality, exactly as it is right now, is healed perception. And I already know my perception is already healed. I already know my perception is already healed. Ah, this is our root affirmation. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Okay, this is a go-to affirmation to center ourselves. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. The holiness means it is entirely. It is entire. It is holy. It contains the entirety of spaciousness. There's no fixation in it. It's holy. Okay, it's not blemished. It's holistic. It's holy. It's entire. It's all-inclusive. It's not that I see part of pure spaciousness as without fixation, and another part with fixation. So let's go over this just a little bit, because what we think that we've been trying to do often is to find something that we think is like, okay, well that doesn't have fixation, or that has less fixation than this, and then say, okay, so I found part of pure spaciousness as free of fixation. So let me now see if I can start clearing out the rest of it. You know, let me just try to see if I can abide in this part that is free of fixation, and then try to clear out the rest. So this is not the vision of holiness. This is a vision of, you know, fragmentation, actually. Partiality, fragmentation. My vision is holy. I mean, it's entire. It's not leaving anything out. It's not fragmented. It's not divided. It's not split. Now I see truly. I see what is truly there. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. There's nothing that is held apart from my vision, okay? It's entire. It is holy. It leaves nothing out. We're not excluding anything. We're not saying it's 99%, but over there in the corner, there's something there which is, you know, not included in pure spaciousness, not intrinsically included. No, everything is, all is. So now I see truly, my perception is healed. My vision is holy. Okay. I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth that there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth that there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Once again, I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth that there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Okay, and because there is no fixation whatsoever, because nothing is ever crystallizing, no appearance is ever crystallizing, our freedom, moment by moment, is still perfect, meaning we can choose a different experiencing any moment. There's nothing that is fixated from what we have chosen, what we're choosing right now. There's nothing that's fixated that binds us to this moment. So we're not bound to the moment. We're not bound to any moment because there's nothing that's fixated. We don't have to pull something up by the roots. We don't have to say, oh, I got to fix this. I got to change. I got to do something with this. How do I deal with this? I got to deal with it. There's nothing that is ever fixated. So we are always abiding in absolute freedom. I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth that there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I'm never bound by any of my experiencing, okay? Because nothing ever fixates or crystallizes in pure spaciousness. And so every moment is totally fresh, totally clean, totally unfixated, and therefore I can shift to any other potentiality I want to this instant, with no residue, no strain, no fatigue, no fear, no residue whatsoever. I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth, that there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Okay. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. There's no fixation. See, healed perception shows me that there's no fixation whatsoever, which means I am absolutely free to choose any experiencing I want without any resistance whatsoever, without any loss, without anything going wrong, without any residue, without any trouble, without any guilt, without worry, without struggle, without confusion, without division, without split mind. So my seeing this fact restores my mind to sanity. There's no more worry about confusion, about split mind, divided mind, about duality, about divisiveness, about fear, about contamination, about troubles of any type. So I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. So this brings in the acknowledgement and gratitude that there is that within us which is always perfectly aware of truth as it is, the unfixated absolute freedom of truth as it is, and that is always gently reassuring us that this is so, this is so. So thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Or thank you, grace of God, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, the spirit of holiness, the spirit of Christness. Oh, hummingbird just showed up. Okay, right on. It seems to have a schedule here. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Christ Spirit, meaning holiness, meaning no fixation. Everything is no boundness, no fixation, no crystallization. Everything, all appearances have the exact same relationship, perfect relationship with pure spaciousness. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. So, remember, we are practicing familiarity. We are walking together in the wow. We are walking together in the wow. We are getting familiar. We're not arguing. We're not trying to prove the ego wrong. We're not putting the ego down. We're not trying to crush it. We're not trying to do anything with the ego. We're only asserting the truth and getting familiar with this. That's it. We're not answering any questions that ego has. We're not trying to appear smart or that we know it all to the ego. Try to get one up on the ego. We're not receiving any awards from the ego of how great we are, anything like that. It's just walking together in the wow, making these assertions, and just we're either asserting or we're feeling the wow, or we're flipping the script, That's it. We're not answering questions to the... It's not question answering here. It's familiarity with truth here. And asserting the truth instead of putting it in the form of a question, which the ego loves to do. The ego loves to ask questions. This is one of its main defenses. It's one of its main defenses. And so, how did we get into this frustrating situation we're in right now? I tried to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality. But this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. Okay, I tried to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality. But this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. This is an idle wish. We had an idle, whimsical wish. I had an idle, whimsical wish. I tried to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality. But this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. And this encapsulates the whole situation. Very simple. Why are we struggling? Oh, I tried to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality. But this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. Very simple. Very simple. Very, very, very simple. And now the prison bars have already vanished without a trace. My perception is now totally holistic. All right? The prison bars have already vanished without a trace. My perception is now totally holistic. No division in my perception. See, it's totally holistic, meaning it's totally holy, meaning there's no exception. There's no exception whatsoever. My vision is now totally holistic. I see the entirety, as it were. I see that there's no exceptions, there's no fixation at all. I don't have to be behind the prison bars, only looking at a little bit and saying, well, maybe that's better than something else. Prison bars have vanished without a trace. The idea of fixation is the prison bars. The notion that there's fixation, and thus that there's struggle and competition between everything, and that there's layers and levels and extreme complexity to reality. There is no such prison bars at all. The prison bars have already vanished without a trace. No trace to these prison bars. They're gone without a trace because there's no truth to them whatsoever. They're causeless, and therefore they leave no trace, no residue. My perception is now totally holistic. My perception is now totally holistic. My perception is now totally holistic. As it were, 360 degrees, like a globe, like an orb, a ball of pure awareness of truth. Excluding nothing. It's not like what's in front of me is not fixated, but what behind me is. No. Behind, in front, to the side, above, below, everywhere. Holistically everywhere. I have this vision, this holistic vision of healed perception. It's all flawlessly unfixated, uncrystallized. Completely free in the moment. In the moment, completely free right now. Completely free right now. So this is a bit of a wow, no question about it. We're working at this, and we are working at this as best we can. And let me see, walking together in the wow. Where is that? I'm not sure. That's okay. We are walking together in the wow. Here it is. Walking together in the wow. Walking together in the wow. This is, all of this is something we're not that familiar with. But as we continue to practice, guaranteed, we'll get more and more familiar with it. As long as we keep the argumentative, egoic questioning belief system, we call it the egoic belief system, as long as we simply put that to the side and don't engage with it, do not engage with it. We just stay with our assertions, and the wow is it builds up. It builds up as we practice. It builds up. It builds up. And it feels a bit of a strain to it. Absolutely, there is, and you may feel tired afterwards, because we've been focusing on this uncharted territory for most of us here, and thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. We're not used to thinking in this way. We're not used to expecting this. We're not used to saying this. We're not used to hearing this. We're not used to believing this. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am experiencing now. Right now, we're not used to this. So, but the more we say it, the more we say it, the more used to it we get. So thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. So the most fruitful practice is the type of practice that this video is presenting. This is, you know, way more fruitful than other types of practice, which might include questions and answers and dialogue and explanations, and you know, and then you're tripping over words, and they mean this by this word or that, it could mean this or this, that. And then we're asserting very directly, thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. And we don't bring up any questioning about it. Okay, these are statements of fact. We are making them statements of fact. And when we practice this way, it lifts us up above the squabble and the complexities and the confusions and the disagreements and the vagaries, the grass swamp of vagaries that has we've been slogging through for so long, you know, that causes such anguish. And anyone can practice this way. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Anybody can say this. So we don't have to go back into the swamp and slug it out with anyone. If they want to get out of the swamp, very simple. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Just start practicing. Right practice. Skillful means. It's that simple. You don't have to argue with the swamp. It's a hallucination. Why argue with a hallucination? There's no fixation. So why argue about means like how to remove, how to successfully remove fixations? There aren't any fixations to remove. And the ego simply cannot understand this. This is very important to hear this, that the ego literally cannot understand that there are no fixations, because the ego believes that it itself is a fixation. So the ego is busy trying to get rid of all other fixations so it can be the only fixation, and then think that therefore it is God. You know, no, the ego itself is a fixation, is a believed in fixation, is the belief in fixation. So when we say there is no fixation, we're saying there is no ego. And so, of course, the ego says, "No, wait a minute. What do you mean by there is no fixation? I don't understand that. Explain it to me." It's really saying, "No, I do exist. I do exist. I am a fixation. I am a fixation. I am." So the ego really, all the ego really ever does is to just repeat this over and over. "I am a fixation. I am a fixation." That's all that it's really saying, no matter how it embellishes it. Okay, an elaborate embellishment of it, packaging it. The picture's always the same. The frame, no matter how elaborate the frame is, the picture's always the same. And it's just the ego saying, "I am a fixation, I am a fixation," repeating that over and over. And there is no fixation. So there can't be an ego. There can't be any fixation at all. We don't need to heal the ego. We don't need to heal the ego of its fixation. It doesn't exist. There aren't any fixations in pure spaciousness. So the ego is saying, well, how am I going to be healed? How am I going to get rid of my fixation? You know, see, the ego believes it is a fixation. Because that's our fundamental belief in trying to be greater than God, that there's a fixation in reality, there's a flaw. So the ego thinks, well, I'm seeing the flaw, I'm the one who's seeing the flaw. The ego says, no, I am the one who is seeing the flaw. And if you say there's no flaws, then there's no I, because this I is relative to seeing flaws, the seer of flaws. The I means seer of flawness. Seer of imperfection. The seer of imperfection is a good definition for I, the seer of imperfection. If we say there is no imperfection, how can there be a seer of imperfection? So the ego is very interested to say, well, how can I get rid of this imperfection I'm seeing? Okay, so in saying that, it's saying there is an imperfection, but I'm all for getting rid of it, you know? And what the ego has us do is say, well, illusions are true, but I'm your advisor on how to get rid of them. This is what's called the false path. This is what doesn't work. So we are recognizing this here. There is no flaw, so there is no seer of flawness. There is no imperfection, so there's no seer of imperfection. Therefore, we don't have to get rid of this. The two, you see, when we recognize this, the two vanish without a trace together, don't they? The seer of imperfection and imperfection, realizing there is no imperfection, therefore also the same concurrently, therefore there can't be a seer of imperfection. This is simultaneously one recognition, actually, you know, gone without any residue. They're never there, never there. Concurrently never there. Simultaneously never there. So what part of the practicing are we in now? We're in flipping the script, right? Flipping the script part of it, you see? How we recognize, oh, they are concurrently, simultaneously never there. Simultaneously never there. To use a term, of course, if they're never there, they weren't even simultaneously never there. But that goes beyond into knowing. So since we're practicing here, we're using terminology. Simultaneously never present. Meaning we don't want to get caught up about which one is not true first. You know, is it the seer that of imperfection that is wrong, primarily wrong, or is it the imperfection not being there that's primarily, and then you get into an argument. No, concurrent, simultaneous, as one, two sides of one coinness. Two sides of one coin, a coin that has never existed. A coin that has never existed. So we're walking together in the wow here. This is very intense. This has been very intense here. Which is what is needed. It's just what is needed. Now, it's intense for me, too, because I'm breaking the ice on this. I'm breaking the ice. I'm bringing this new format of sharing here, presenting this in a more direct, more intense way for us. And I just, you know, I knew I had to sort of take a next step, and I've been struggling with it, and been able to finally figure out. I spent all day trying to get this darn thing to work, and hopefully it's worked. Breaking the ice. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Walking together in the wow. We most certainly are. Prison bars have already vanished without a trace. My perception is now totally healed. Totally holistic. I tried to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality, but this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. God has always remained perfect. God has always remained perfect. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. So, what part of the practice are we in there? Just what we just did? Assertions, right? We were just making assertions. Okay? And then when those assertions build up a real punch, what do we do? Oh, okay, walking together in the wow, or what we say is full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Let's see if I can dial up those three aspects. There you go. Assertions, full stop in the wow, flipping the script. Okay. So, we can say that yes, we have a practice. We have a basic practice. We have a basic practice. Now, of course, the ego will ask all sorts of questions about it. But what we say is, well, the practice is very simple, and we practice it instead of discuss it. We actually practice it. And so let's either make assertions or either be quiet, full stop in the wow, or we're flipping the script. Now, you may find that you're talented at all three of these. I found out that I'm able to do all three of these, have talent in all three of these areas. Flipping the script is we look at the situation and we say, hey, you know, the ego's been trying to make me look at it this way. I don't have to look at it this way. I don't have to look at it that way. I can look at it this way. I can look at it that the ego never existed. You know, the ego's been telling me I have to fix the flaw in reality. Hey, wait a minute. I can look at it like there isn't any flaw in reality. You know, and you start thinking, maybe there's not any flaw at all. You know, and so you're flipping the script. The ego has this upside down and backwards. So we flip it right side up and right side forward, if there is such a phrase like that. So flipping the script is it's not really problem solving. It's getting our ideational clarity aligned with truth. So it doesn't get used against us. We say, hey, wait a minute. Let me change. You know, flip that around. Let me flip how I'm viewing that. At least, you know, conceptually, how my belief about that. Let me turn that around and this way. And see it this way. Let me see it this way. Let me see how it feels when I do this. Or we could use this flipping the script to simply, the ego's trying to intimidate us, and we just say no. You know, no ego. We don't go along with the script that the ego is giving us. See, the ego tries to script us. It's always trying to put us into its script. The ego is always trying to put us into its script. Names, numbers, labels. Get away from pure abstraction. The ego is terrified of pure abstraction, because pure abstraction, holiness, holistic vision, vision of healed perception, vision of Christ, vision of sameness, vision of oneness, healed perception, shows us there isn't any fixation anywhere, right? Perfection, pure abstraction, no exceptions. That means the ego is not an exception either. It doesn't exist. As a flaw, it doesn't exist, does it? So the ego is terrified of our minds going extreme right-mindedness, as we might say. So they'll say, well, how many times do I need to say this affirmation, and how can I, what do I, how can I label this affirmation, and how do I categorize it in relation to other affirmations? Is this a better, a number one or number two? Is it better than this or better than that? It constantly tries to stay within limitation, specifics, stay away from abstraction. Okay, this is the ego's survival. And so it scripts this, constantly scripting what it wants to hear from you, where it wants your attention. It wants your attention on non-abstraction, okay? Non-abstraction, meaning division, fragmentation, differences, judgment, layers, levels. All of this is based on the belief in fixation. All this is based on the belief in imperfection. None of it is true. Pure abstraction simply recognizes that there's no exceptions whatsoever. There is no fixation. Seamlessly smooth. This seamless smoothness, this absolute seamless smoothness of the ground of being, pure perception, the ground of being, the aspect of God, the ground of being aspect of God, which is the aspect along with awareness and the play of appearance, the play of experiencing, the awareness of this, and the unfixatedness of all this, our freedom. This is all of this is God. So I started out last night with just this idea. I was taping, and I tried this. The picture it has something here where you can put in a graphic, and it had not worked for a long time, and I clicked on it and it worked, and I said, wow. I said, wait a minute, maybe I can put up some graphics here. And then I said, well, what kind of graphics? And then I said, well, why not get a background that I'd already had made. I did this background in a Photoshop like program, GIMP, I believe it's called, GIMP. It's a free Photoshop like program, and I put together various elements, layers here, blended layers, and had a nice background. I said, why don't I just type something in here? So I did, and I started typing and saving these slides, and I was able to load them into this program, and it's working, as far as I know, and this is great. It's really great. So it just came about by some inspiration, asking the Holy Spirit. I said, I know I need to do something, a little amplification, something has to be tweaked in some way. I just didn't know what it was, and I was stuck there. And I feel that we've sort of been going through a stuck phase over the last week, actually. About the last week has been a week where we realize we need to up our game. Okay, we need to up our game. And this happens, okay, this happens. I've experienced this many times where the world is becoming so egoically fixated that we need to up our game just to remind ourselves of truth, and not get pulled into the script that the ego is insisting that we follow. The ego is getting more and more arrogant and demanding. The more demanding it gets, the more velvet the glove that it puts on. It's a soft, delicate, lacy glove, and yet it's wielding this incredibly powerful sledgehammer now on us. Telling us this is the script that you have to be on, and the more demanding the script gets, the more the ego tries to soften this up by lots of lace and frills and velvet and velvetiness in the packaging. But the demand to follow a script, the egoic script, is becoming totalitarian in this world. Totalitarian. Okay. And you know, it's like you have to dress it up now. It's so totalitarian. You got to put like as much lipstick on a pig as possible. You know, put a petticoat on a pig and lipstick, and you know, the more totalitarian it gets, we have to be distracted from it. We have to be distracted from it by something, you know, charming or pretty or whatever that distracts us from the totalitarian script that is being demanded of us by the ego. The ego's getting very nervous right now. And maybe there's some great liberation coming, huh? You know, instead of feeling like, oh, this is terrible, it's the end of the world, maybe there's some great liberation coming. It's possible, isn't it? And the ego is trying desperately to, you know, script a non-liberation, no liberation, keep us bound to confusion. So there's been these various stages I've noticed throughout the years where, like, you realize, oh my gosh, I've really got to up my game. I mean, it started out back in the 70s. 1978 was when I realized I had to go for broke. You know, this absolutely cannot wait any longer. I have to make a fundamental dedication of my life to you know, truth. And I did that. And then throughout the decades, there have been times, like I remember, as what was it, 1999, August 18th, I believe it was 1999, I experienced this tremendous experience where I saw where the world is going to go now. The Holy Spirit showed me. My awareness was taken to another realm, another planet, some other star system, a planet there, and this planet was completely fixated on technology and gadgets. Totally fixated and obsessed. And I felt like I was going to die. My spirit was going to somehow die. I said, this is horrible. And then I realized this is what's going to come to this world. This is what's happening. And you know, then the internet really got, you know, roaring about that time. And it's been nonstop since. So I had to pick my game up at that time, which I did. Went through a lot of considering my valuing of the world, the valuing of the spiritual path that doesn't really go so fast. You know, is there really value in the slow path that does that at this time? No, not really. You know, all the pageantry and all the rituals and all the stuff that we've done throughout the thousands of years, is that really that valuable that I'm willing to, you know, fail to get free of the ego script? No. So I was able to drop all that and then get started here on YouTube with urging people to go faster and faster, urging everyone to go faster and faster. Pick up your pace, pick up your pace. So then there have been other times when I realized, you know, have to be more intense, more direct, more simple, and pick up the pace. And so the last week has been another phase of this. So you may have been experiencing this, feeling this the last week. You feel like, you know, wow, maybe I'm not going to make it, or maybe I have to pick up my game, or maybe I know I've got to somehow, you know, reach a even greater clarity and pace, and you know, can I do it? So it's been a real struggle the past week, big struggle. And so here we are now. On a Sunday, what's today? April, April 12th, 2015. And we've picked up the pace here. We've picked up the pace. We've gotten more focused. So don't worry if you have struggles during these periods of transition. That's fine. Just pick up the pace. That's all. And once you pick up the pace, you say, "Oh, okay, I'm okay. I'm right on track. Imagine if you're going down a railroad track and there's some saboteurs up ahead on the rail line, and they're working to with the rail bars, the way they push the rails over. They're working to divert the track onto a side track. And they're actually running towards this area to get there fast so they can divert the train. And you're in the train and you're saying, oh my gosh, I got to get past this attempted diversion before they're able to push the track and divert the track off. So you're pouring more, coal in the furnace of the train, or increasing the diesel fuel, whatever. You go faster, burn, more speed. You're cannonballing that train down the track right now, and whew, we go past this diversion point just before the ego gets there and cranks the track, but we're still on track. We're going straight down towards liberation, towards healed perception right now. So the ego loses again. Yeah. Now, it's tough to shift format a little bit like we have, because we're used to a certain format, and familiarity says, nah, just keep it the same. It's too hard to change it. So it's been very difficult to introduce this format here. It's been very difficult. But we've done it. And this kind of helps us focus in our practice as assertions, full stop in the wow, and flipping the script. We do have a practice, okay? We're not orphans here. We're not spiritual orphans. The inspiration has come from the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit pointed out, hey, this has been done before, similar. This is high teaching. This is very good teaching. This is very good way, skillful means. And we're right in alignment with the very best of all the best teachers in history. And we're doing what they recommend. And so go for it. Keep going for it. So we have this simple practice. We're making assertions. Or we may be flipping the script, which is generating this, clarity and more enthusiasm and confidence and assurance. And then we may be full stop on the wow. We're just quiet for a while. We're just wow. Sometimes the truth hits us very strong. And we just want to sit there quietly. It's just wow. Now, we've done this without stimulants. We've done it without stimulants. Last week I was just saying, I just gotta drink some Coca-Cola. How can I do this? I'm stalled out. I gotta go faster. How can I? And the Holy Spirit said, no. Just stay with what you're doing. So I didn't, even though I was exhausted, and said, no, I just have to be patient, and let me get it this way. And so fortunately, we have something here that is working for us. And no stimulants, no letdown. Momentum is still pure momentum going here. So we can use these little snippets of assertions, right? We can use these snippets of assertion. This may help us focus in these assertions. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Right? Therefore, I'm finished. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I have already attained healed perception. Do I have a vision of Christ? I already have the vision of Christ. From a different tradition, you might say, I already have Buddha mind. They might say, tradition would say Buddha mind. Or we can say vision of Christ, healed perception. I already have healed perception. In Hindu, Hinduism, they might say, well, I already, Satchitananda. I already have Satchitananda. I am Satchitananda. pure spaciousness, consciousness of that, of all that's appearing in pure spaciousness, and the bliss of this experiencing, the bliss of this experiencing. Satchitananda, Buddha mind, vision of Christ, vision of oneness, vision of nowness, vision of sameness, healed perception. I already have healed perception as the only attainment, and I've already attained healed perception. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I've already attained healed perception. So I'm feeling a bit of the wowness right now, actually. Feeling a bit of this wowness. Full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Now, this doesn't mean to get up and walk and stretch and go get a snack. And no. This is a very focused, intense, you're watching your mind. You don't let your mind get off the practice. So if the mind is going to wants to go somewhere, send it to assertions or flipping the script, but not to answering any questions. Not to answering any questions that are being posed to you or struggling. Do not struggle. That's the ego. There's no struggle in the truth. There's for us, it just there is this wow. Okay, that is the only struggle there is a continuity fear. And that's all we need, is to get, just let that evaporate. That's it. There isn't any other struggle. Once we evaporate our continuity fear, the vision of oneness will dawn upon us. The healed perception will dawn upon us for sure. Healed perception will dawn upon us for sure. I always pray or assert, affirm, as if I have already received what I want. And I'm thanking God for this. I'm in a thankful mood. I'm in a positive mood of mind. I realize I've already got it. So why do I need to struggle to get it? Why do I need to struggle to get it? Why do I need to plot to get it? Why do I need to strategize to get it? None of that is in play since I already have it. So this wowness is the realization is I already have it. I already have healed perception. I already have healed perception. So it's just this wow. There isn't, I don't have to say, well, how am I going to get this? Or what do I need to do to get this? Or what have I been doing that's giving me trouble to get this? Or, you know, what is my plan to get this? How long is it going to take me to get this? All these questions need not arise for us at all. At all. We just stay a full stop. And the wow means none of those questions arise. They're foolish, completely foolish, since I already have it. Yes, I already know that I already have field perception. Yes, I already know that I already have healed perception. Yes, I already know that I already have healed perception. Now, we're going long on this video. We keep going because we want to get as much progress as possible, meaning much familiarity as possible. You know, 2 minutes is 2 minutes. There's not a lot of familiarity that happens in 2 minutes. 5 minutes. 10 minutes, you know, it is what it is. Now, we don't want to burn out, okay, but we don't want to shortchange ourselves either. We really need to stay on track at this juncture in the world situation. We really need to stay on track. Now, I almost wasted my weekend. I just said, I don't know if I can do it. But thank God the Holy Spirit found a way here. So it's not a wasted weekend. We're on track. We're on track. We're powerfully on track. We're engaged. We're staying engaged. We're staying engaged. With familiarity with truth, familiarity with healed perception. We're staying engaged with simplicity, the simplicity of healed perception, that is simply dropping the idle wish, the foolish whimsical belief that there's some flaw in perfection, There's some fixation in pure space, just dropping this idle wish. It's nothing but an idle wish. There isn't any fixation there. Now, this intensity might make you feel hungry at some point. I don't know that. So you might even gain some weight. I've gained some weight. I'm trying to, you know, keep it from running away with me. But because it's really, you know, it is stressful in a good way. It's right use of stress, I would say. Like the news is so great. It's stressful. I saw the parents of this young golfer today who won the Masters, Jordan Spieth, and his parents were, you know, his mother, for instance, was just overcome. You know, she just crying, and she said, the news was so great. What she sees, she just can't hardly believe it. You know, her young son, 21 years old, is a, you know, king of the golfing world, and it's just, she was just so, you could tell, just shaken to the core by this, you know, as you would think any mother would be. And that's very tiring. I mean, I'm sure later on she's just going to feel like, wow, I am so tired. I am just so tired. I just need to rest. This has just been so stressful. to see the you know, astonishing success of your young son just being, you know, being extraordinary at what he's doing, the parents and his friends and everybody are just, they're elated, and but yet it's just stressful, very stressful to be so elated, and they're just overcome by what has happened. There's an example. Okay, we are being extremely successful here. Okay. Like winning the Masters. It's like winning the Masters golf tournament here. Like, you know, we're being extremely successful on the spiritual path now. We are using brilliantly skillful practices. And we're so on target, you know. We're so aligned. We're so much directly going towards familiarity with what we need to be familiar with. We're right on track with what we need to be familiar with. And so it is, the success is stressful. Success is stressful. Keeping your cool, you know, keeping your cool as you realize, wow. And not thinking too much about the, you know, ultimate success. Not thinking too much about that. Just staying practicing. Staying practicing. Golf's a great metaphor for the spiritual path. As he's finishing up these final holes, he realizes, hey, I'm going to win. But you can't be thinking of that. You have to keep focus on what you're doing. So we know we're going to have healed perception. In fact, we know we already have it. This is the practice. I already have it. I already have it. So there's a fine balance of I already have it and continuing to practice. You see, we do need to continue to practice. We continue to practice by saying, I already have it. I already have healed perception. Healed perception is the only attainment, and I've already attained healed perception. This is how we win. This is how we win, by right practice, skillful means, skillful practice. So I'm feeling the wow now. There's no question about it. I'm feeling the wow. It's coming on strong. No question about it. But okay, so we dig a little deeper. We dig a little deeper. Because the ego script is coming on strong. It is coming on so strong that it is right to say that it has shifted faces right now. It really has. I mean, some of the stuff that's coming to my attention, the Holy Spirit brings it to my attention. I just say, wow, huh. It's completely Orwellian. You know, I mean, it is so Orwellian now. Maybe they should just have a picture of some lipstick lips is all they need to show, and just saying, lies are true, you know. And maybe that's just a commercial they're going to show pretty soon. They're already there pretty tacitly, just a smiling pink lipstick, red lipstick, pair of lips underneath it saying, lies are true. You know, that's where we're at, basically. We're getting very close to being that blatant now. So there's this new era of extreme blatancy right now. Extreme blatancy from the ego saying, you need to be on script. Okay, well, we say ego, we are on script. We're on script with the Holy Spirit. Okay, we're marvelously on script with the Holy Spirit. And that's the only script we need to be on script on, because the ego doesn't exist. So how can it have a script, actually? We're just imagining it. We're imagining we need to do that out of what? Continuity fear, actually. Continuity fear. We've like spooked ourselves, but there really is no ghost there, you know. It's like, oh my God, I thought I saw a ghost. I gotta run away from that. And then we say, wait a minute, maybe there wasn't a ghost. Maybe I can stop running, you know. Like that. Yeah, we've spooked ourselves, but there aren't any flaws. There is no flaw with reality. Reality's perfect. We don't need to follow a script that diverts us from this recognition. We need to follow a script which gets us familiar with this recognition. That's the Holy Spirit's script. So we're going to either follow a script from a non-existent ghost, the ego, a non-existent ghost of our imagination, or we're going to follow a script from the Holy Spirit, which the Holy Spirit says, you know, practice, practice, practice here. We're just practicing getting familiar, which evaporates our continuity fear. The only problem I have is the continuity problem. I don't have an egoic script problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. The egoic script problem doesn't exist, therefore has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Only healed perception has value for me. Only the vision of Christ has value for me. Only Satchitananda has value for me. Only Buddha mind has value for me. Only vision of sameness has value for me. Only vision of nowness has value for me. Only the vision of pure awareness, pure consciousness, ground of being, only the vision of God has value for me, right? So the continuity problem is the only problem I have. We just aren't used to recognizing that there is no flaw. We're just not used to. We're used to hallucination, imaginary hallucination. Hallucination is imaginary, actually. It's not there. There is no fixation. We're just imagining it. But we believe all these things represent fixations. They do not. We believe these appearances represent different degrees of fixation. There's no fixation. Therefore, there's no degrees of fixation. We believe that these things represent some layers and levels of fixation. There's no fixation at all, so there's no layers and levels of fixation. So when we go through this phase shift, you know, we're going to feel turbulence in our lives. We're going to feel turbulence. So it hasn't been easy this last week, for sure. I felt a lot of difficulty, a lot of turbulence. And I kind of said, like, wow, this is tough. But just stay patient with it. Stay patient with it. I tried various things that didn't work well, you know. I tried this graphic or that graphic, no. And then just settled on this very simple format. I knew I had to find some format, and just settled on this very simple format. So how are we doing here? I just had something weird happen on the computer, but I think if we're still trucking along, certainly we are. Keep on trucking. except we just shifted gears. So the wow is really humming right now. It's hissing, it's humming, it's reverberating. The good news is it can be exhausting. But the more we get used to it, the less exhausting it is. This is what's so important to hear. The more we get used to the good news, the less exhausting it is. What we're doing is we just continue to double down on the good news. If I gave you the good news I gave you a month ago, you might say, oh, that's easy. Yeah, it doesn't tire. So I need to keep pushing, doubling down, more intense. So it's still, wow, it's exhausting. This is really a workout. But we need that. We need to succeed with the Holy Spirit's script. And in fact, we need to assert, I've already succeeded. I've already, healed perception is the only attainment there is. And I've already attained healed perception. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I know I'm already enlightened. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. And thus I am already enlightened. Healed perception is enlightenment, and thus I am already enlightened. So this video is here for any time you want to practice. You can go back and watch this video. It's a very intense practice. And of course, we'll have more intense practices to come, if that's possible. I don't know, this is pretty strong. But yeah. Remember, sit quietly in your practice, sit quietly in your practice. As you're viewing the video, sit quietly. Don't have a bunch of stuff going on, you know. Maybe have a glass of water there, already there, so you don't have to get up. Oh, I need to get up and take a glass of water. You sip the glass of water. Do what you can to remain still, quiet, focused, poised, considering in your mind, mentally focused in your mind, in the mind, level of mind, which is ideas, abstraction, pure abstraction. Mind is perfectly abstract. So stay in this abstraction, extreme right-mindedness, you could say. Hang in there, tough it out, don't quit. Hang in there, tough it out, don't quit. So I'm really feeling the wow now. It's building. It's building. It's like I say, it's like eating a hot pepper. It builds. At first you say, well, that's hot, but it's not terrible. And then later on it builds more and more, and you say, wow, that's very strong. And then you try to put out the fire, and it won't go out, you know. So it can be like that. Not as suffering as a hot pepper, but it's a good feeling. Like you're working out and you can feel the burn of the workout, and you'll be saying, this is great. I know I'm really having a great workout. Wow. is full stop in the wow right now. See, what this practice does is it realigns our belief system, as it were, reorients us towards truth. And the reorientation percolates through the entire belief system. So, just like an intense workout, intense, the whole body feels it. We're feeling our entire belief system, the entire mental construct, as it were, is feeling this reorientation. Very intense. That's great. So as the ego continues to try and push its Orwellian upside down, backwards, script upon us, we respond more and more by flipping that script and making the assertions, more and more powerful assertions, more and more intensity. It's really become a comedic, actually. The ego's quite a comedian. It's become so blatant and Orwellian, and it's actually funny. I find myself laughing at times. It just cracks me up how ridiculous the ego is, you know, basically saying, hey, guess what, folks, we got great good news, lies are true, and lies are now true, and everyone's like, oh my gosh, what an oracle, the ego, you're so wise, you're so divine, what a wonderful news you're giving us, that lies are now true, and we can now worship you, and we're going to be happy forever after, you know, and it's like this fairy tale there, you know, and it's so crude, you know. Sometimes it can't help but, you know, crack up at how crude the ego has become now, and it's desperation. You know, it's catering to, you know, very, very crude, catering to a severe lack of reasoning. Warning, if you close the program now, that the capturing will be stopped. Would you like to continue? Yes.